وَقُلْ رَبِّ زِدْنِي عِلْمًا.
Two of the Jewish tribes who were already in Medina accepted him as a guest.
Yes.
He exiled two of them.
I've
and
heard
he
your question. Can
all
I
of the men in the third, and he enslaved their wives and children.
What a lie.
Okay, excuse me. That's propaganda. We want the truth. Okay.
I do accept that there were
can
two
I speak? I am the speaker, madam.
Who didn't follow Muhammad?
Now, you are
when
Christian. Now,
them,
there must be some manners.
Auntie, you asked the question. Let him answer.
Okay.
Let him answer.
Okay.
Yes.
Right.
With evidence, you answer. Then judge upon the evidence.
Me. Okay, brother. Okay. Okay, thank you very much for your question. Look, as Muslims, we know our Islam. We know our Quran. And we even know your Bible.
You, know
you asked me a question about the Jews in Medina. The answer is this. Those Jews, they had a treaty with the Prophet Muhammad, with the Muslims. But when Quraysh from Mecca, they sent an army in the fifth year of Hijrah. An army of around 10,000. Madam,
yes.
Can I answer? I don't need your help. I can answer myself. Okay, thank you. So the Muslims in the Battle of Ahzab, Battle of Khandaq, in the fifth year of Hijrah, fifth year of Prophet migration, around 10,000 soldiers were sent to wipe out the Muslims in Medina. Okay,
where is your reference to that?
It's our knowledge. We know.
Where is the reference?
Okay, I'll give you a reference. Okay, excuse me. Do you accept references from your own books?
I accept the primary sources like Ibn Ishaq.
I'll tell you what.
Yes, okay, who was the earliest biography of Muhammad.
Excuse me.
Bukhari, we accept.
Madam, we do accept, we have references, don't worry, let me tell you, we Muslims are so good, Islam was so good, Islam was so right, Islam was so acceptable, that one Arab, one Muhammad, peace be upon him, preached for nearly 23 years.
Yes.
In Mecca, 13 years.
Yes.
In Medina, nearly 10 years. Nearly 23 years he preached.
In
the country we now know as Saudi Arabia. Okay, he doesn't even answer in a good way. So I'm just going to carry on speaking. Okay, because this is Speaker's Corner and I am a Muslim speaker. And as Muslims, we know how to speak. As Muslims, we know how to answer questions. As Muslims, we know how to debate. So coming back to our Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, coming back to the beginnings of Islam, during the times of our Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So nearly 23 years he preached in Mecca, in Medina, in the country we now know as Saudi Arabia. And yet, that is why I say Islam is so beautiful, Islam is so nice, Islam was so truth, Islam was so acceptable. That is why now in the year 2016, in the Christian calendar, in the year 1438 in our Islamic calendar, now we have millions of Muslims in North America, millions of Muslims in South America, millions of Muslims in Africa, millions of Muslims in Asia, Muslims nearly 1 million in Australasia and in Europe. Now we have Muslim countries. Bosnia Herzegovina, capital Sarajevo, is Europeans, majority Muslims. Next door to that, we have Kosovo, Europeans, Kosovo, capital Pristina, Europeans, majority Muslim. In Europe, we have Albania, capital Tirana, European, more than 80% Muslim.
Yes.
So people have accepted Islam.
Yes.
Why?
And your Sharia law says,
Sharia law.
Anyone who the current manual of Sharia law says that anybody who leaves Islam, the Islamic faith, deserves to die.
Your Bible says that.
Okay, excuse me.
Show you where your
the Bible
says
also
that?
Says that.
Your Bible says that.
The Bible
says that.
Also says that.
Maybe you should follow your Bible.
Your Bible.
You're going to dig a grave for yourself, Auntie.
You should follow your Bible.
Let me
come on.
Don't know.
Don't lie to
let
everyone.
Me tell you.
Period of time within a small tribe.
Okay. Excuse me. Sharia is a whole
Deuteronomy 21.
Islamic law. Let me tell you. Let me tell you.
Deuteronomy 21.
I'll give you an example. This country is Great Britain. In this country, the law is English law. Okay? According to English law, if a person commits murder, any crime, I'm just mentioning murder. If a person commits murder, the police will come into action. They'll catch a person who committed the murder. They will take him to the court. The murderer, he will end up in the courts. In the courts, there will be the jury. There will be barristers debating, arguing. And then the judge will have the final say. The judge will sentence the person for murder, whether life or whether for murder for life or manslaughter. How long? According to Sharia law.
Excuse me.
I haven't
been
mad at a court. Okay, brother.
Yeah, I'll give you an example.
Thank you.
In my own country.
Yes. Are you a Muslim?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you.
So I saw many Christians.
Yes.
Who were going to convert to Islam.
Okay.
They were burned alive. It's no good.
Okay, thank you very much. Okay, but we know. That's happened. I mean, who was Muhammad, peace be upon him? He was an Arab. Look at the Muslims today. Excuse.
Deuteronomy 13 says the same.
Okay. What did she say?
Read it.
You keep on talking.
Never killed anyone.
Okay,
no.
Let me give you.
Do you want me to read about what he did?
You not understand, you liar.
Oh, you're going to just, you're here for propaganda purposes.
It's my brother, thy son, thy mother, thy daughter of
God.
And Christ is secret is saying, let us go and serve other gods, which thou hast not known, nor thou hast fallen. Then you take them and stone them, if they will call you to worship any other god. That's what it means.
In the Quran, madam, in the Quran,
they asked for the
Anbiya
to judge them. What did he use to judge them? He used the Bible.
Surah chapter number 21, verse 107. Allah tells us in our Quran, Allah says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We have not sent you, O Muhammad, but as a mercy for the whole world. Okay. Muhammad, peace be upon him, he was merciful.
Mercy for the Jews.
Okay, to the Jews. Here. Those Jews.
They were judged with the Bible.
Jews
those Jews.
Well, yeah, you are Kafirun.
Those Jews. Yes, yes. Are you a representative of the Jews?
Jeremiah
13:14.
Read it.
I will not pity, nor spare, nor have mercy, but destroy. That's in your Bible, Auntie.
Okay, destroy.
So is God kind of merciful, or is he destructive?
According to the Bible.
That's your book.
That's your book.
For living today, do you not take Muhammad as your example?
How can they change the book of God?
Jesus, Luke 27:19. What did he say? What did he say?
In the final judgment, if you do
bring those who don't agree with me in front of me and slay them. Jesus said that. Luke 27:19.
Our Quran never changes. Your book, for example, our Quran, everywhere, anywhere, is the same from the beginning to the end. 114 surahs or chapters, more than 6,600 ayahs verses, 80,000 words,
more than 20 books,
more than
only one Al-Quran Al-Kareem.
Your Bible,
Ya Mu'ale,
your Bible. Your Bible, you can read loud. Yeah, read it loud. Go on.
Our Lord,
yeah, go on.
Our Lord Allah,
go.
The Lord,
you know,
of
that.
The Prophet Muhammad, the Lord, yes, of Prophet Jesus, Abraham, David, Noah, Aaron, Moses.
Yes, everyone.
Says in the Quran,
this example,
in the fourth chapter of the Quran, verse 82. Do they not then consider the Quran carefully? Had it been from other than Allah, they would surely have found therein much contradictions. Now we stand here in Speaker's Corner to challenge you. Ahlan wa sahlan, Habib, we challenge you. We challenge you.
Okay, challenge.
Find some.
Okay, find some. Okay, go for it, inshallah.
Find another one. Let me read it.
We challenge you.
We
challenge you publicly.
Okay, okay. Muhammad.
Habibi.
Muhammad,
find it. Muhammad. No problem, find it.
Muhammad, find another one.
Give us one example.
A verse from your Bible. Yes.
Are you a Christian?
Book,
yeah?
In the book.
Okay. Give one example.
Muhammad.
I challenge you to defend my claims now against these contradictions that stand in the Bible.
Okay.
One
okay?
Second, one second.
How about that? No, auntie, don't get scared. I challenge you.
No,
I challenge you. Okay.
Can you tell me, please?
Don't worry about that. I've challenged you.
I've challenged
you.
You
know what? All right, watch this. Before I go into it, guys. Before I go into it, in the Bible itself, it confesses that the Bible is a farce.
Read the verse.
The Bible is a lie.
Read the verse.
Jeremiah 8:8. Allow me to speak. You cannot prove that I'm an infidel if I haven't spoken. Do you know who I am? I don't know you. You don't know me.
Carry on.
Allow me.
Wait.
Allow me to start and to finish.
No, wait.
In Jeremiah 8:8. Thank you very much.
I'm going to read his own words from the Quran.
8:8.
How can you listen to me?
How can you say?
After you finish it,
thank you.
How can you say we are wise, but we have the law of the Lord, when actually the lying pen of the scribes has handled it falsely?
Okay, Muhammad, let me read this. In your Bible, in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 20, verse 16, the Bible says, however, in the cities of the nations, the Lord your God is giving you as an inheritance. The Bible says, do not leave alive anything that breathes. The Bible says, next verse, verse 17, completely destroy them. Listen to your Bible. Respect your Bible.
Oh, that's okay.
Respect your Bible.
Okay. Subhanallah. Now it's okay.
Where's the double standard? Why the double standard,
Muhammad?
Come on, you're a wise lady, aren't you?
The Bible says, completely destroy them. Hit the Hittites, Amorites,
Malachites,
Canaanites, Perizzites, Hivites, and Jebusites. Is this a Bible? Kill.
Hey, I've got for them.
Okay, go on.
Guys, give me 1 minute of your time.
Go on.
60 seconds of your time.
You carry out.
For you, anti-fascist.
Read it.
Now, all right?
What about Mohammed?
You talk about the Sharia being unjust.
Go on, brother.
That God is unjust.
Oh my God.
She will carry on.
Where are the miraculous signs?
Deuteronomy 13.
Read it.
Deuteronomy 13. Give me 60 seconds. It's a little bit long. If thy brother, the son of thy mother, or thy son, or thy daughter, or the wife of thy bosom, or thy friend, which is as thine own soul, entice thee secretly, saying, let us go and serve other gods, which thou hast not known, nor thy fathers, namely of the gods of the people which are round about you, nigh unto thee.
And from
the one end of the earth, even unto the other end of the earth. Now listen carefully.
Is this the way you Christians preach when a Muslim
thou
is speaking?
Thou shalt not consent unto him, nor heartbreaking unto him. Neither shall thine eye pity him. Neither
apostasy in the Bible.
Shalt thou spare. Neither shalt thou conceal him.
Yes.
But
walls of Jericho have got
and
to
here
fall down.
For you is your
they
answer.
Have got to be given
and
many
here I
miraculous
you.
Signs.
I've gone through
so
it now.
So they know it's from God.
But,
where is the
okay,
miraculous
well, sign?
Let me just
tell
let me give you the cherry.
Carry on, carry on.
Here you go. Here's the sugar for you.
Bring it.
Thou shalt surely
that is your
kill
example.
Him.
Ours is
thy
our
hand
Jesus Christ.
Upon him to put him to death, and afterwards the hand of all the people. And thou shalt stone him with stone that he died, because he had sought to crush him from the Lord thy God.
You want to shout louder?
Okay, Mohammed, in your Bible, in your Bible, in the book of God,
this is your book. We challenge you. Our Lord challenges you. You already know
no, you are. No,
you are lost in God's gospel. You are a
loser.
You are six questions. You are from Pakistan. I'm not going to repeat.
Muslim, majority Muslim.
You are
Muslim.
I'm asking you.
Allah, 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 Muhammad. Are you a Christian? Okay, let's talk to each other. Okay, was Jesus God? I'm asking
There's
you.
There's no point in discussing. He doesn't understand.
Okay, right. Okay, brother, give me a chance.
No, no,
so,
I don't give you a chance. I want to speak.
No, 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 no. I'm telling my brother, stay. Don't run.
No, no.
Stay.
I'm not running.
Stay. Stay.
You need the mic to shout louder.
Excuse me. This is the debate now.
This is not a debate. This is a monologue.
Listen.
You are speaking.
Don't no, you've been invited. You've been invited.
Don't run, man. Listen.
You've been invited. Long time.
Don't run.
Have you listened to me?
Mohammed, Mohammed, leave him to me now. Excuse me.
Respond to
ask
me.
Asking.
Respond to Allah's claim.
Ask me to be quiet.
You should
excuse me.
To
okay.
What are you
okay.
talking about?
Sir, sir, sir. We Muslim. We Muslim. Excuse me. What? I want to speak to that Christian. Christian. Excuse me. We Muslim. We believe in the Holy Quran. Do you, as a Christian, do you believe in the Bible?
You need to listen.
Do you believe in the Bible? Answer the question.
You need to listen. You need to listen.
Listen, are you my teacher? Are you my professor?
Yes, yes.
I am the speaker. I want to debate with you. Excuse me. Excuse me. I'm giving I want to speak.
If someone in this world.
Brother, I want to give him a chance.
Sorry.
Okay. Okay. Brother, Mohammed. Mohammed, okay.
I don't know what they're speaking about.
Excuse me. Excuse me, we are giving you a chance. Let's have a debate. We Muslims, we believe in the Holy
claims.
Quran.
Your colleague here said some claims
pardon?
That the Bible is a lie. I told him he's infidel by the words of the Quran.
Okay, don't do this. Okay. Forget him.
Are you listening
bring
to
the evidence.
Yes, now forget okay. him.
These are always old arguments.
So you say the Quran.
Bring the evidence and then let the evidence speak. I let your God speak. I let
you
want
to speak with him.
And you said 8:9.
You said something. I'm
Matthew 7:22. Let's go to Matthew.
Okay.
You said something.
Shall we speak more?
Okay. Quiet, please. You said something.
I will
second.
Be quiet. You be quiet.
Wait
bring
second.
Up your
it's
God.
Here. It's here. Wait a second. You said the Bible is a lie, right?
The old argument.
Is the thing you said.
Yes, I'm over
this is what you say.
I don't understand that verse.
The current. I know what he's going to bring.
Brother.
That we have to refer back to the previous scripture.
He doesn't understand
are
that.
Are you listening?
Mr. Mullah, Mr. Sheikh, bring your tafsir.
Okay.
Imagine the politicians.
Let everybody hear what we're debating about. Excuse me. Excuse me, sir. 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 I want to speak with you. I want to give you a chance. Look, we Muslims, we believe in the Holy
May
Quran.
Continue?
Okay?
May I continue with the gentleman?
Pardon?
Go ahead.
Well, here
the Bible is a lie. Did you say it? Did you say it?
Yes. Your Bible says it's a lie. You're telling me what I said. Jeremiah 8:8 says it. That means your God said it's a lie.
Let him speak.
He's Googling.
That's your Jesus speaking for you.
Did you
say Jesus would never say that about the Quran?
Did you
neither would Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Did you say
and Isa alayhi salam all Muslim love Isa alayhi salam.
What did you ask me about the Bible being a lie? Question. I will refer it back to what I said previously.
I'm asking one question. Have you said that the Bible is a lie?
Jeremiah,
yes or no?
Your God says the Bible is a lie. Your God says the Bible is a lie. Why should I leave my religion that has no faults in it to come to your religion?
Have you said the Bible is a lie?
It's a very hard job for you.
Where are you going?
Have you said? I'm just asking you.
Jesus said.
I'm asking you.
Jesus said.
So you are denying you said.
No, I said it in accordance to your book.
I'm asking you. Have you said the Bible
is a lie? Who here is confused with what I'm saying? Is there anyone that's unclear? Please.
Is it? Is it a tough question for you?
Is it a tough question?
Yeah.
Is it really?
Did you say or not? 5 minutes
upon
back.
Upon what did
he's
I say?
He's saying
upon
he's
what? Saying
was
minutes.
Anyone unclear that was here? What did I quote it upon? Jeremiah 8:8. What does Jeremiah 8:8 claim to say?
Who's Jeremiah?
How can we be wise? When the lying pen has held it, handled it falsely.
Okay. Do you want to
educate?
Do you need to
educate us?
Who, no, I'm asking book. You. You quoted Jeremiah. Who is Jeremiah?
We are not here.
Guys,
to quote, except
please,
for
when somebody comes and quotes something which he doesn't know at all, please ask him. What does he know?
We don't need his shoe size.
Who is this guy? Who's Jeremiah?
Who's Mark? Who's Matthew? Who's Luke? Who's John? Who's Peter? Who's Paul? Did any of them even see the crucifixion of Jesus Christ?
Mamma mia! I'm asking you.
Mamma mia!
What's your mamma mia? What's your mamma mia?
I don't want to correct you. All right, then tell me how what you do know. Because your Jesus tells us that your book is false. Your book is false. Jesus says that. I'm sure that not everyone here is a Muslim. Not everyone here is a Muslim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and we will say it again, in Surah An-Nisa, verse 82, that he challenges those to find contradictions in the text. Now, what does the Bible say as a reciprocation of this? Is there a reciprocation in the Bible? No. There's a conflict in the Bible. In the Bible, Jeremiah 8:8, it says, how can we be wise when actually the lying pen of the scribe has handled it falsely? That's the Bible. So when we come here, as Muslims, and we go to say that there is no deity worthy of worship but your Lord, Master and Creator Allah, we are here to challenge you to bring contradictions to our text, which is the reason why we bow down to God 5 times at least a day. Now, if I was here, if you come here to preach Christianity, that is a book that
See,
this is a true Muslim. He's a proper Arab.
You are here to criticize, but you are not here to interfere.
He's your Muslim.
You are not listening.
You're not here to educate.
Muslim number one, and you're rubbish.
Go back to Egypt, you ugly bum.
Yes, okay.
Tell me, you don't know Jeremiah. I don't know Mark, Matthew, Luke, Paul, or John. You know them. We know more about our prophets than you do about your Lord.
Jeremiah was a prophet, so
how
what?
How can you quote people?
We know more about our prophets than you do of your Lord.
Happy Christmas to you. Happy Christmas for you.
Supposing, guys, my name was Jack Smith.
Abdullah. Yeah?
Supposing my name here was Jack Smith,
yes.
You know more information about my personal information than you do about Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, Paul. Who are they? Who were their surnames? What were their family names? What are you talking about? You know more about me now in one statement that I've made
Michael
than you
Jackson.
Do about any of yours. Michael Jackson.
No. Khomeini. Jackson. Because my wife.
We have many eyewitnesses. You only have one who said.
You have eyewitnesses. All right, let's go to eyewitnesses. Look what the four, Matthew, Mark, Luke and John say about the sign that was posted upon the crucifix. The statement that was on the crucifix of Jesus Christ. Let's look at the contradictions. Let's look at the contradictions. Where's that chair?
It's gone.
Look, in Matthew, the sign that was above the cross of Jesus Christ read, and above his head, they put up the charge against him which read, "This is Jesus, the King of the Jews." In Mark, it said, the inscription of the charge against him read, "The King of the Jews."
Yes.
That's the first conflict.
Yeah.
First conflict. Now, Luke.
What about Islam?
Hold on. Now, of Luke. Now, there was also an inscription above him. "This is the King of the Jews." That's the third conflict. Now, the fourth conflict is in John 19:19. Pilate also wrote an inscription and put it on the cross. It was written, "Jesus the Nazarene, the King of the Jews." How can you follow text from men that cannot even agree upon their own truth? How can you agree upon these men? And you want to speak to me of Jeremiah on top of this, my friend? Bring me one harmonious chapter of the Bible that does not conflict with another, please. And then maybe I will try and listen to you a bit more. And people will listen to you more. I am not as confident as you feel. I have certainty in my belief because there is no conflict in Islam, and we stand here every Sunday. We stand every Sunday here.
There is a conflict.
Not here in Arabic. We stand here every Sunday to call towards truth, to call towards the upgrade of Christianity and the upgrades of the Jewish scriptures, which is to uphold the same monotheism belief that came with the first prophet and to Muhammad, which was La ilaha illallah. There is no deity worthy of worship but your Lord and Master, Allah. How dare you? How dare you worship a man who died? How dare you worship a man you believe sat on the toilet? How dare you do that? Have some respect for your Lord.
Jesus.
How many of you
never shitted?
But we don't say he's God.
They worship a God. They use toilets.
Anyone else? We're here till Maghrib. We're here till the sun sets to call towards the truth of Islam. To call towards the truth.
What time are you going to come to the
beginning? We are merely here as believers.
That's
our prophet, peace be upon him, says,
"Ya Maghusi, Ya Allah."
Seek knowledge from the cradle to the grave.
He also says,
"Knowledge is the key to worship." Knowledge is the key to worship. Ibadah. So when we are here, guys, I'm not someone who is a professor of Islam. I'm not someone who is a professional public speaker. But I come with something that is the inheritance of the prophets. And that is La ilaha illallah. When Abraham, when the father of Ibrahim, your prophet and our prophet, his father used to send him to the marketplaces because his profession was manufacturing statue idols. Abraham, our prophet, he used to pass a space of water on the way, and he would dip the idols that he was given by his father to sell, and out of obedience he would do this. And he was given these idols and he stuck them into the water, and he said to the idols, "How can you save me if you can't save yourself?" Now, my brothers and sisters and friends, this is true Islamic monotheism. Do not fall into deceitful ways. Don't. Find the contradictions in the Quran, and I will shake your hand and we will go and look for the truth together if Islam's not the truth. But do not stand here and mock a religion that doesn't have any faults in it. Because if you do and you believe in the Lord, then surely you know that there will be a day of reckoning for you, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises. Huh? You can joke about it, my friend. And I pray for you. And I pray for you, inshallah. I will pray for you. If you don't want prayer for you, and you don't want truth, then go. All right, mate. Then go.
That's in the
house. And go and make an audition.
That's Khomeini that does that.
Because here, we are here with sincerity to give truth to you. That's it. You're here to take the piss. Anyone here that wants to listen to a man make a fool of himself, by all means, mate, stand on the fence. We'll give you the spotlight. We'll give you a round of applause.